Doctor, please explain that ascorbic acid is not vitamin C. Yes, ascorbic acid is not vitamin C. Have I seen anything that indicates that either one of them is ineffective or more effective for this? You know, again, I think the whole issue of vitamin C is still very unproven state. That was the major topic for yesterday. Got a lot of interest, a lot of focus on it. For those of you who didn't see it, all the way back in Linus Pauling's time, he's quoted many, many times, or named many times, as the only guy that's won, not one, but two, had a major focus on vitamin C. He thought vitamin C would help us prevent heart attack and stroke due to damage in arteries. He thought it would help with diseases. And there's been a major debate going on about that ever since. Well, that debate got rekindled in a big way, specific to people with acute respiratory distress, people on ventilators for problems like COVID-19, just last year. A Dr. Merrick in one of the Virginia ICUs did a 40-person trial. Didn't get vitamin C, 40 did get vitamin C. This was intravenous vitamin C, and he got a huge improvement in response and in death rate. So it created yet a whole new firestorm of debate around the vitamin C issue. A couple of randomized, funded, well-designed clinical trials were done. You can look them up in JAMA, or again, you can go to my video from yesterday. The citris-ali trial and the vitamin trial. It was very interesting. You would have thought that would have put an end to the question. For a lot of people, it did. But here's what happened. They didn't want to kill vitamin C if it wasn't the largest study. It wasn't thousands and thousands of people. And they didn't want to kill vitamin C by just looking at death rate alone. So they looked at things like inflammatory markers and a thing called the SOFA scale. SOFA helps you, it's a gradation to tell you how much better somebody's getting when they're on a ventilator. Well, here's what happened. The inflammation markers in the SOFA scale didn't improve. On the other hand, the death rate improved significantly. So not only did it not solve that vitamin C debate, it just made it worse. So very interesting story. If you haven't heard it or seen it before, go back to my video from yesterday.
There's nothing like a community. We saw that in the Louisville event. People got together and started talking about how they've had challenges and successes in preventing their own heart attack, stroke, or chronic disease. It became very clear that you don't have to be a doc with a full-time 30-year career in preventive medicine to understand this and successfully prevent heart attack, stroke, the number one killer and disablers of people. You don't have to be a physician to prevent eye disease, kidney disease. All you have to do is think, listen, and become part of the community. Now, how do you do that? Go to the membership login on our webpage, and as you can see, you can get right in. You have to sign up if you haven't signed up already. And I've already signed up. I've already gone in. It's very simple, very easy to understand. In order to help encourage this, after the success and the positive emotion, the positive impact that we're seeing with these events, we're saying, look, we need to offer more of these services for free in order to help grow this community. So you'll see us starting to do drawings for the webinar event, the courses. We've got a book coming out in about a month. We'll be offering that. Even full-blown evaluations, providing those for free for folks that, again, help us grow the community. So if you'd like to find out what the most recent rules are for the most recent drawing, just come to the membership page. Thank you for your interest.